Hey there, Mercedes here from PrettyWebz.com, and today I'm going to show you how to make an agate texture inside of Photoshop. I've done this texture video before, but we did have some audio issues with that, so I'm redoing the whole thing for you right here. Plus, we're adding the gold and a few other style things that you might find handy when you're creating your own agate. So we're going to go ahead and get started. I'm going to start this one with a new document, 1000 pixels by 1000 pixels. I'm actually going to bring this down to 72 pixels because I find that some people do have problems with the liquify filter when you have a very large document. So what you might want to do is start with a bigger document, say 3000 by 3000, and bring the resolution down. When you're done creating using the liquify filter, you can always upscale your image if you're having a lot of problems with that liquify filter, and I'll go over that here in a minute. But I'm going to go ahead and click create for this one. I'm going to unlock the layer, and we're going to click on this little icon right here to reset your colors to black and white. So we want black and white for this one. You can make these colors any colors you want. It's only two colors for this, but the colors will blend in. So I've had some people ask me about how can you do three or four colors. So with this method, you can only do two colors because you have your foreground and background color, but you can always add in colors later on. But we're going to start here with the black and white colors. I'm going to come here to filter, render, and fibers. And I'm going to bring this up a little bit because I do want to have a lot more black in here. So something like this. It just depends on what you want. You can always just go randomize down here and get something that you want. So you can either go stronger with this or less strong. I'm going to leave mine at 2 because I don't want it as strong. So I'm going to click OK. And from here, I'm going to come up to filter. This time I'm coming to liquify. So this is where I find that a lot of people are having problems. You come into liquify. I'm going to bring the size of this down. Not the size, but the view of it down. And I'm right here in this little forward warp tool. So make sure that you're on forward warp. I have pin edges selected. My brush size for a 1000 pixel document is at 800, so just a little bit smaller than the document itself. You can bring this way up if you're working with a larger document. And then I have my density at 29 for this and pressure at 100. And I'm just going to bring this down. So what we're trying to do is just get those stripes in here. Once you get all of the stripes in something like this, then you can also use this right here. This is the bloat tool, so you can come in here and just click on an area where you want to make it wider. So I'm just gonna go like this and then go back to my forward warp tool and, you know, work with it like this. Maybe you don't want it as big. But this is really where you're going to be molding and working with this texture. But the agate texture is more about these lines right here, all of the variation in color and the lines. And that's what we're working with. I'm going to leave this here and I'm going to show you what I'm going to do with that in a minute, because I have had questions in the past about how you would make kind of like little, I guess, puddles in the middle. So we're going to work on that. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and leave this as it is. Bring that down. And I'm going to click OK. Now you can see what just happened here. The screen turned black. So sometimes you're going to have to work with this. It's all going to depend on your settings. What I'm going to do is come up here to Photoshop, Preferences, and I'm going to go here to Performance. Over here in Use Graphics Processor, I'm going to Advanced right here, and I'm going to go ahead and choose Normal. So I'm going to click OK, OK again, and I'm going to go ahead and try this one more time. What I'm going to do is fill in this little area right here. So I'm going to add a new layer. I'm going to come over here and choose the Smudge tool. I'm going to choose Finger Painting right here, and I'm actually going to switch this to white. I'm going to change my strength here to 100%. So you'll want to make sure that you're using a hard brush. So hard round brush, mode is normal, strength 100%, and we're using finger paint. I'm just going to add a little bit of paint right there And then I'm going to press the X on the keyboard to bring the black. And then I'm just going to add, you know, just a little dot there. From there, I'm going to bring down my strength to about 25% and uncheck finger painting. And then I'm just going to come through and push this out. We're just adding kind of a little element where it's kind of smudged out a little bit. And I'm going to push that right here into this crevice here. So it just looks like it's part of this design. And I'm just using my mouse right here to just push this. You don't even need a tablet for this or anything. If you like, you can add a little bit of gray in there. So I'll just turn finger paint back on, bring this all the way back up to 100%. And I'll choose a grayish color. I'm going to choose something from the actual document and then just, you know, add that in there. Turn finger paint back off. Bring this back down to about 20 to 25%, and then push that out again. So you're just at this point just mixing these colors together. And you can go inward, it doesn't have to be pushed out. I just want this to look like it's flowing into this other area right here. So I'm just going to bring it out just a little bit more. Okay, and once you have that in there, this is just another option right here. So you don't have to do this. You can have a much simpler agate like the one I showed you in the first video. So I'm just trying to give you a few different design options for this one just to make it a little bit more interesting. So we'll go ahead and leave that as it is. And I'm just going to grab that bottom layer. I just held the shift key. And then I'm going to grab both layers, command and the letter E, to make that into one layer. Okay, at this point, I'm going to go ahead and add a new layer. I'm going to come up here to select color range. And I have my fuzziness at 20%. I am working with the midtones right here. So you would go to this drop-down menu, and you're probably going to have this sampled color selected. We'll just choose midtones. Keep your fuzziness at about 20%, and then your range is really going to depend on the design that you're creating. You don't want too much, and you don't want too little of the gold. So, you know, the more range you put in there, the more you're going to have in your selection. So right now we have all the grayish areas, and I'm just going to make this even smaller. So I have my range at 98 to 127. You can make this smaller or larger. The larger the range, the more of it will be gold. But again, too much gold doesn't have the same impact. So just be careful with that. I'm going to go ahead and click OK. And I've made a selection here. I'm going to press Command and Delete on my Mac or Control and Backspace on a PC. And you can just click that a couple of times just to make sure that you get a solid color in there. Command and the letter D, Control and the letter D to let that go. We've just basically added a solid color, and it doesn't matter what the color is. It's just going to pick up on the background color and fill that selection there with that color. But we're going to come here, double click on the far right hand side to bring up the layer styles for that layer that we just created. And I'm going to choose pattern. That's going to add that gold in there. So I have mine scaled to about 50%, and I am using the high shine pattern. This is a pattern that we made in a previous tutorial, so I'll go ahead and link down at the bottom in case you want to learn how to make that texture as well. So you can go ahead and just add that high shine texture. It's a foil texture in there. And then I'm also going to choose bevel and emboss, only because I want to add a little bit of dimension, right? I don't know if you can see it right here in this area. Let me bring this over here, and when I turn that off, if you pay attention, like right up here and, you know, down at the bottom, you'll see that it does add a nice dimension to this. And you're not, you know, you don't need a lot. We can, the depth I'm using right here is 261, our size is 4, and everything else is basically the same. Angle 90, altitude 30, and then black and white for our highlight and shadow. And I'm going to go ahead and click OK. So from here, command or select both of the layers, command and the letter G to make a group, and I'm going to make a copy of this group. I just held my option key and dragged that up. That just duplicates the layer. And with this one, with this copy selected, I'm going to press command and the letter E. That's just going to flatten that layer. So we still have the original down here. But we have this flattened copy so that we can work with that. We keep this one just in case there's something, you know, maybe you just don't like all of this depth that you've added in this area. You didn't notice it before, whatever, for whatever reason, you want to make sure that you keep your originals. That's all this is for. If you're sure that you love this, then just delete that. But we're gonna work with this one right here. And you could right click and convert this to a smart object, and then we can add our filters after, but I'm not gonna do that. So I'm gonna zoom in here a little bit just so that you can see what it looks like at this point. So there's a lot of detail in here and it looks really nice. But if you wanted to add a little something extra, we can come up here to filter. Noise, and we can add a little bit of noise, so that's going to give you an interesting effect as well. So I have mine at about 5%. You can go maybe 6 or 7%. I'll just go ahead and leave this one at 5 and click OK. So you're just getting, you know, just a little noise in there just for some interest. And then you can also come back into filter, go to filter gallery, and add something like paint daubs. This is actually something that someone left in one of the comments, which I found really interesting as well. So it does add a little bit more shine with this. You'll have to work with the paintbrush size and sharpness. I tend to keep mine pretty low, and I usually use the brush type simple, but you have a whole bunch here that you can choose from. So, you know, definitely make sure to check these out to see what effects you can get from this. But for us, we're going to go ahead and keep it at simple. And I'm going to click OK. So paint daubs, by the way, is under artistic, and it's going to be right here. So it'll be the third row down in the first column. So I'm going to go ahead and click OK. Now, again, if you don't like all the texture, you can easily just go back to this and... As far as bevel and emboss, you can remove that if you like, or make that embossment a little bit smaller, because it just seems we'll go 100. So we get a little bit of that, but we don't want to go over the top with it. Again, as a reminder, you can come up here to Photoshop preferences and performance. And this is going to help you with that liquify filter if you were having problems with that. You can come in here to advanced. I actually had to move mine to basic because I'm recording and it was giving me that black screen no matter what I did using the normal. I usually use advanced or normal, but for this one, I actually did come down to basic just to get this to work for me. So, you know, work with these settings if you do get that black screen. And if you wanted to bring the size of this up once you've created it in a lower resolution, you can come up here to image size. We're going to choose a resampling of preserve detail 2.0, and we're going to bring the resolution up to 300. You can see that it automatically changes your height and width. I'm just going to bring that down to 1000 because I want the same size image. I just want a much higher resolution. So I'm going to go ahead and click OK. And now I have that higher resolution, which is going to be much easier to create at a lower resolution and then bring that up. So these are just little ways around that graphic problem, that black screen and the liquify. You can also add some adjustments here. So I'm going to go ahead and add a curves adjustment. We're just bringing down the shadow slightly and bringing up the highlights just slightly for this one. I'm going to come in and add another... I'll add the brightness and contrast to this as well. So I brought my contrast up to about 24 and I brought my brightness down just a little bit to about 10. And I'll leave that as it is. Let's check out the vibrance. Vibrance is sometimes a good one for this. So I'm going to bring up the vibrance to about 20 and I'll leave that. So I've got three adjustments here. I've got curves, brightness and contrast, and vibrance. And these are the three I recommend you working with, especially when you're working with golds and metallics. These will really bring out the color in your gold. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure to like and share it. If you want to make sure you don't miss any more videos, please consider subscribing to this channel. Visit prettywebz.com for more design resources and tutorials. Until next time, thanks for watching.